Alright, what's going on, guys? Trev back again. We're going to bring you another video. This one's going to be doing my weekly review for this week's episode of The Walking Dead. This week we got to see The Walking Dead Season 4, Episode 5, Internment. Three words. Best episode ever. Alright, so as always, my reviews do contain spoilers, and if you have not seen this episode, you definitely don't want to watch this and have this episode spoiled for you. This one was a special one, so if you haven't seen it, don't watch this. Go watch it, then come back and watch the review afterwards. And here's a quick picture of some pretty cool fan art from Jim's Nerd Nation. I'll put the link in the description so you guys can check it out. He creates his own fan art based on the Walking Dead television series. He also sells the prints for about $8 each. So very cool stuff. This week's episode for me, man, when I was first... Okay, so at the beginning of the episode, I was watching it, and, you know, most of it was like along the same lines of what we've seen so far this season. You know, you've got the prison there. Yeah, we've seen it before. We know everyone's sick. We know what's going on. We've seen it before. And then about, you know, I want to say about after maybe a quarter of the episode, this thing went from like, okay, yeah, this is getting repetitive to this is absolutely amazing. This episode was the by far the scariest episode, I want to say, of the Walking Dead television series we've ever had. By far ever had. Probably only second to this would be the season 2 premiere on the highway scene with Andrew in the RV. That was pretty scary, but this was even more scary. It was dark. Everything was dark out, you know, dark at night and inside the prison. Tombs or prison cells or whatever you want to say. Just super dark. The zombies look just grotesque and really gnarly. You've got Herschel in there, and he's kind of sealed off, and he's trapped inside. Maggie tries to break him out, but she can't, and then you've got all of the manpower, or at least a good portion of the manpower that's not sick, is gone with Tyrese, Bob, Michonne, and Daryl not even being there. Then, of course, there's Rick, who's doing the best he can. Herschel is overworked like crazy. Also, of course, got the prosthetic leg, so he's older, too. So he's not the type of shape to be fighting or killing walkers by himself, really. Then you've got his assistants are Glenn and Sasha, who are sick to begin with, like brutally sick. You can see under their eyes and stuff, like brutally red and... Man, what an exciting episode. So scary, the most terrifying we've ever had. The best Herschel episode we've ever had. You know, this episode for me, like, Herschel is such a cool character after watching this episode. This is like his episode, you know, I would have to say, when you look at the whole scheme of it and everything. The amount of time we spend with him, the struggle, and especially like the line at the end where Daryl calls, who did he call, somebody a tough son of a bitch, I think Sasha, and then he calls Herschel a tough son of a bitch, and then Herschel replies, I am, you know, in his accent, and I just, oh, that was such a great scene. I love that line. Just so many for Herschel in this episode. So many amazing scenes all the way through, and really cool to see him used like this as a character. In the comic book series, we never really got, you know, those kinds of, that kind of feeling. Like he came in as a character, he was a cool character, he helped out with some different things, but it wasn't like it is in the TV series where, you know, you really feel like he's this this just amazing character, especially after watching this episode. And of course, to boot, or to add on to that, at the end of the episode, we have the man has returned. I've been waiting for it all season, and just when we least expect it, I was thinking that they were going to end the episode with Rick going to talk to Daryl after everything that's going on, but no, they end up ending the episode with the governor standing there looking at the prison, you know, all evil-eyed and everything like that. I just, oh man, I geeked out so bad when that happened. I thought that was just amazing. So very cool stuff. Just as I was calling for it and I was saying in my review last week, or my predictions, that I was starting to just kind of get a little bit tired of the whole, you know, illness arc, story arc. They just wrap it up at like the perfect time, you know, they wrapped it up. And it was climactic too. Like, that was a climactic ending to this whole little story arc of this infection that's going around and everything that's happened with it. And of course, now we are introduced to the return of the governor at the very end. Oh man, good stuff. This is one of my favorite episodes of The Walking Dead ever, by far. This is right up there with Clear for me, and you know, all of my other favorites, say the last one, the season 2 premiere, all of those great episodes we've had throughout the series. This one for me is one of those, definitely. It depends on what you like, though. Some people don't really like the scary. See, that's the thing about The Walking Dead, though. If you think about most of it, the last few seasons, they haven't really been that terrifying or that scary. That horror aspect of the show was kind of lost in season 3. It became more of like an action, the governor versus, you know, the Woodbury versus the prison. But that sheer terror horror aspect, I think of a zombie apocalypse, was kind of lost, you know, a good portion somewhere along the road. They sort of lost that fear, or we as viewers lost that fear of walkers, and this episode just brought it back 100%. Dark, gritty, hopeless at the beginning, and then of course rising to the occasion, Herschel and the rest. Just a very, very good climax with the governor. There's just so many things about this episode to love. I mean, I can't, you know, I just can't express in words for me as a viewer how fun this was to watch this episode. It was just amazing. In terms of score, I'll give this episode a perfect 10 out of 10. I don't think there's anything wrong with it. The beginning starts off nice and slow, and then it builds up to what's one of the most exciting parts in all the Walking Dead television series we've seen so far. The walkers waking up inside of the prison cells, Herschel being somewhat defenseless, not wanting the kids to see, you know, especially the one with the girl walker that's chasing him, and he's kind of baiting her along with the shotgun. You're just thinking something's going to go wrong when that happens, because the same thing happened to Lizzie a minute ago. Now, what was she trying to do? I really don't, she's a weird character. So Lizzie's character in this one, first of all, she's baiting the walker, and I was thinking, oh, she's got something up her sleeve. She's going to trip it, or she's going to do something and knock it over, or something of the sort, right? And then she falls down the whole bit, and Herschel has to save her, which was a pretty cool scene for him, where he threw the walker over the little barrier type thing, you know, metal gate type thing, the prison for the walkway. Her weird part for me, she's you can tell, you know, if you watch closely, she's nuts. She's playing with the blood with her foot, you know, and she's just kind of looking at it and asking, like, is it over? That kind of stuff. She's, oh man, I can't wait to see what happens with her later on and how crazy she is. Again, probably filling the role of Ben from the Walking Dead comic book series, hopefully. Or maybe they're throwing us through a loop as we're thinking she's going to be like that, and she won't be. I guess we'll see what happens with that. We didn't see resolution to the whole Carol thing from last week. You know, the Rick gets back and he starts letting a couple people know. Who did he tell? Told Maggie. And he didn't even get a chance to tell Daryl yet, or the others that were gone. So we'll see how that goes next week. I'm sure we'll probably see that dealt with. Although it looks like from the promo at the end of the episode that next week's episode is going to be heavily focused on the governor. So maybe it'll be like his entire, you know, an episode entirely dedicated to him. I'd like to see if they were going to do, you know, the governor, if they were going to do like a flashback type thing, where we could see everything that happened to him in the last 6 or 7 months. I guess now it'd be like 6.5 months or whatever, because of the episodes we've seen. What's happened to him, you know, it looks like from the promo he was completely by himself. So it doesn't look like he was with anybody. And, you know, you can see the fire and all that. And it looks like he's kind of dealing with his will. He's lost his will to live, you know, or at least the motivation to really do much of anything. He's just kind of sitting around by himself. So I'm really excited to see what happens with that. I'm excited to see where that goes, and another great development for the episode. So the highlights for me would be obviously Herschel's, coming to the rescue for this one, the governor, and him returning, of course, because that's huge when we least expect it, right? That was worked in nicely. The whole Rick and Carl thing, I forgot to mention that so far. That was an awesome sequence right there. That, for me, really elevated this episode because we've never really seen, you know, the characters really just let loose and say, oh, screw it, and just grab the guns and just start laying out zombies like that. Just start laying them out. And that was really cool, especially the fact that they worked in both Rick and Carl. So the scene meant more than just them blasting zombies and clearing them out, but that it also is sort of like that Rick's starting to trust Carl again, and you know, Carl kind of consoling Rick at the end of it, telling him everything's going to be okay, Dad. You know, him sort of evolving as a character and becoming more of a man, especially from the time we first saw him. Like, if you watch the first episode and then you watch this, or the second episode, because that's when we meet him, right? And he, or is it the third? Second or third, we see him, and then when he finds his dad in Tell It to the Frogs, and he goes and he hugs Rick again. If you look at Chandler Riggs when he's that young to now, it's like almost, it's like you forget completely where he started out at, and then where he's at now. So very cool development for him, Herschel, Maggie, Glenn, Lizzie as well, Rick, and of course the governor. So amazing episode. Zombie kill of the week, I'd have to go to, there were so many zombie kills this week, it's hard to say. I think if I have to pick one, I'd probably go with the Herschel where he killed Caleb, or Dr. S, you know, when he broke his arm and he stabbed him. Because, you know, it's kind of like Herschel's dealing with, you know, the Bible at the end and everything. He's dealing with his emotions and whether or not he should be doing this or he shouldn't, and putting characters down and all that kind of stuff. So that was really good stuff, that kill right there, and everything that happened with him in this episode. Let's see, is there anything else I wanted to mention? I mean, I'm trying to, right now I'm going to try to reduce the length of my reviews. Sometimes I go on close to 16 to 20 minutes. And, you know, I noticed from the statistics, most people don't watch it all the way through. So for this week, I'm going to try just kind of cutting it a little bit shorter. So I'll just wrap it up. Well, Glenn's still alive, so that's cool. Sasha's still alive. And just an amazing episode. Tons and tons of great scenes. So I'll wrap it up now. Terrifying, scary, one of the most frightening episodes of The Walking Dead ever. Great development. Oh my God, the governor's back. And just an amazing episode overall. Best episode of season 3 so far, or season 4 so far, guaranteed. One of the best episodes ever. So anyway, let me know what you guys thought about The Walking Dead season 4, episode 5, Internment. I'm still buzzing from it. I gotta watch it again. It was that good. Stay tuned for my predictions video. I've been putting them up on Mondays, so I'll put it up tomorrow. I'll put the link in the description to that once it's up, or you guys can just click the channel and check it out. And if you haven't liked or favored the video, and if you want to support the channel, please feel free to go ahead and do that. And also, if you're a new viewer, you haven't checked out the channel yet, please feel free to subscribe. Anyway, that's it for this video, guys. I'll see you for the next one. This is Trev, and I'm saying peace.